Hi, I'm Manolo Morales from KHON2 News here at the Daniel K. Inouye Airport, about to get a briefing with the Hawaii Department of Transportation as far as what happened with the power outage that occurred this morning. All the power is now back up here with Tim Sakahara with DOT. I guess if we can start with when did the power come back on?
Yeah, the power came back on in full to Terminal 1 about 10:15 this morning. It was out for about an hour, maybe a little bit less than an hour, to Terminal 1. So when that happened, that did mean that things like the TSA checkpoints, any computers that are in here, you know, that scan people in, were all down. So that did cause some delays with Hawaiian Airlines specifically, which is the primary airline that operates out of Terminal 1. They had about a dozen airlines or so that were impacted. But fortunately, the airline is very good at working through situations like this. They were able to hold some planes for a little bit longer to be able to accommodate passengers that may have been running a little bit behind due to the activities this morning. And everything is really back to normal as of this point right now. I can also say that all of the 9 security checkpoints, the TSA security checkpoints located throughout the airport, are operational. TSA staff is doing a very good job trying to get people through as quickly and as safely as possible.
I guess one of the trickiest parts was because you couldn't get the passengers to go through the security lines here, they had to go to the other terminal, so they had to walk, and then they would need to come back and walk over to this terminal if their flights were here.
It depends. Actually, Hawaiian Airlines has its gates all the way through the A gates, which is in Terminal 1, but they also operate out of B and C gates too, which actually do spread over to Terminal 2. So depending. I mean, it would be someone's preference, depending if they wanted to walk from Terminal 1 to Terminal 2 security checkpoints, which is a good point to note that no matter what airline you're on and whichever gate you happen to be assigned to, you can go through any of the 9 security checkpoints in the airport and get to your gate. It just might be a matter of if you have to walk a little bit farther.
What can you tell us about so far what caused the outage and you know, why it lasted that long? Or can you tell us?
Well, there was an outage with the Hawaiian Electric Company transmission line, and we're looking into HDOT officials and the HECO officials are all working into exactly what happened and if anything could be remedied to maybe if there's anything that needs to be addressed or looked at or maybe modified to maybe help make this impact a little bit less in the future.
Okay, because the airport does have a backup system for if there is even like an island-wide outage. Yours is supposed to kick in and basically turn the whole system back up on with this other system.
Correct. So, for example, even the Terminal 2 here at Daniel K. Inouye International Airport did go out, but within 2 minutes or so, it kicked back on. And everything kind of worked as it's intended to do. So our folks and HECO folks will kind of look into to see if there was any sort of issue with the Terminal 1 and why it was down for about an hour. I can also say, too, that there's a whole process for a situation like this, especially with an airport the size of Honolulu. First and foremost, the air traffic control tower never went down, was never impacted. So if there was a plane on approach to Honolulu, for example, it was never impacted or had any sort of issues. Secondly, secure doors throughout this facility are operated on our backup battery power. So those never lost any service or security aspect as well.
So at no point at any time where the security locks were ever compromised in any way during the whole outage.
Correct. That is absolutely true. You still would need your AOA badge in order to get through that security checkpoint area. And even at that, as a second level of security, there are security personnel that monitor those doors anyway. But yes, the primary is that battery backup system and power that does operate the secure doors and did operate as they're supposed to.
Okay. So I guess one of the big question marks here is why the backup system in Terminal 1 didn't come back right on like it did in Terminal 2 and even Terminal 3 if that was actually affected.
Correct. So that's exactly what our folks and the Hawaiian Electric folks are all looking at. Sometimes there could be positive when something like this happens because it might identify something that maybe needs to be worked on or improved. So if there is something that needs to be improved to try to make it even smoother in the future, that's what our crews are looking at and trying to determine.
Now, I know that what was a couple of years ago when the state was still trying to test that backup system and there was having problems of it kicking back in. I mean, is it Is it the same problem that we're dealing with still, or do we know if that's the case?
Well, it's still to be determined. But yes, there is a relatively new backup power generator here at the airport. Our folks are working with it and trying to determine if there was any sort of issue with that. It may not have been. I mean, it may just have been, a power outage. And, sometimes as things kick back on, it could be just like at someone's home, like a circuit may trip and just flipping the switch back on. It could be something like that. I don't know. That's what they're looking into and determining what exactly it was.
Because obviously there were passengers who were frustrated by the long lines and having to go back and forth and stuff like that, and some concern that an airport would be without power with that long, though. What do you say to that concern with having an outage for almost an hour?
Well, fortunately, it was a relatively minor outage, so any inconvenience is certainly something that we don't want to happen to people, but it was restored in full within the hour. That did have some residual impacts, though, for sure, especially with the security checkpoint lines. And when it did come back on, it was about 10:15, which is already the start of the peak travel day. So basically between 10 a.m. to about 1 or 2 p.m. is the peak travel time anyway. Honolulu, the airport here in and of itself, sees an average of about 100,000 passengers in and out every single day. And it's even higher in the summer months because that's just an average, right? So we're entering into the peak time, and something like this happens, it's going to have an impact. Fortunately, it's been clearing out very quickly. Right immediately when the power was restored, this terminal was packed with people. And it's been able to kind of correct itself very good. And that's a credit to a lot of people, Hawaiian Airlines and the airline personnel, TSA and their workers that are working, airport officials. So everyone is kind of really does work together, collaborate to try to get everything back to normal as quickly as possible.
Yeah, and if this, you were saying, actually, if this outage had happened maybe around this time or later in the day when it was in the peak time,
correct,
it would have been more complicated in a sense.
It would have been had even a greater impact, if you will. But again, we certainly appreciate everybody's patience. We thank people for understanding. At times, fortunately, things like this are rare, but occasionally a power outage like this can occur.
Do you know? I know. Hawaiian said they had about 12 flights delayed. Do you know overall how many flights? I don't know if you can.
That's about it. I could say, fortunately, there were no cancellations of flights, which is great. I know Hawaiian Airlines was working diligently to try to hold flights as long as possible to be able to accommodate any passengers that were still making their way through security or making their way to the gate. So that's great. There shouldn't be any other airlines impacted, primarily because it was just Terminal 1 that was impacted by the outage. Everyone else, all the other airlines, shouldn't have any sort of impacts from this outage.
And I don't know. I mean, with the vendors, were they impacted in any significant way or any of the other operations here?
Yeah, certainly. If there were any of the stores like the restaurants or Starbucks and things in Terminal 1, they would have been impacted as well. So we apologize if people weren't able to get a snack or coffee or anything like that prior to their flight.
Okay. And as far as we move toward the rest of this day, it really is getting back to normal. It looks really busy right now, but this is normally this time of the
day. This is. I mean, we're at midday, near midday right now. So this is the peak travel time anyway of the day. But it does look like things are moving quite well. TSA has a canine unit here, which does add to efficiency of the security checkpoint. So it looks like, things are operating as they should be at this point.
Any idea how long it would take to find out what happened with the outage at all?
I don't. I mean, I'm expecting it would be relatively quickly and to try to determine exactly what went wrong and if there's anything that could be done better.
Okay. Thank you very much. Tim Sakahara with the Hawaii Department of Transportation. And as you said, the airport is busy, but this is the normal busy time. Just some of the few lingering effects from the outage that lasted in just under an hour. Of course, we'll have more tonight on KHON2 News and on KHON2.com.